In this video, we're going to give you a brief introduction to the MuckStopper system. I'm joined by Nigel James, our Research and Development Director. First of all, Nigel, could you just tell me a bit about how the MuckStopper idea came about?
So ultimately, the problem we're trying to solve is to stop the dirt and debris getting into the pipes and into the sewer runs,
the drainage system.
Yeah. And yeah, early 2020, we decided that we'd try and start our journey on making a product to fix the problem.
During a construction project, there's a lot of different ways that drains can get blocked up. Yeah. Can you just run us through sort of how that comes about, how that happens?
Two ways of viewing it really. One's around the plot drainage, and that's like the dirt and debris getting knocked, like the manhole cover getting knocked off inspection chamber and the dirt going down the chamber, and potentially the top riser or so getting knocked off. And then there's the roads and sewers, we're calling them. So the road manholes and the road gullies. So that's a slightly different problem in that it's more silt and runoff from the roads, which is going down the gullies and the manholes. It obviously causes a lot of time and aggro at the end of the job. When you jet the runs out, they can be substantially blocked at that point. So this range is really to try and stop that as much as possible. You'll still obviously need to jet the runs at the end of the job, but rather than it taking a week or two, depending on how badly blocked they are, it could potentially only take a day or so, and also give the developer the peace of mind that there's nothing else has gone on down the line.
And obviously the blockages, that might even lead to the sewage backing up and overflowing into open water.
Yeah, nobody likes that, do they, sir?
No, so the drainage system is there to perform a important function. And then the other thing, I suppose, is with these drains getting blocked, that could have a bit of an impact on a house builder's reputation, couldn't it?
Yeah, that sort of thing, that sort of bad news does travel fast, unfortunately. It's not fun for anybody, is it, to have blocked drains once you've moved into a house?
Yeah, absolutely right. I mean, a house is one of the biggest investments most people make in their lives. And to get to buy your new house from a developer and then find the drains are all blocked.
Yeah, it's the last thing you need, isn't it?
It's the last thing you want on the snagging list.
Yes.
So on the roads and sewers, if we start with that, what are the problems there and what products have we come up with to solve that?
Yeah, so we're talking about the ironwork in the roads. Let's start with the gullies. A plate with a hole in it as such, and then there's like a bucket which hangs in the hole. So all the, and that bucket basically collects the silt, and when it's full, you empty it. So there is a bit of maintenance to that, and yeah, when it's full, it would be a mechanical lift.
And when will that be available?
We're looking to get that to the market around the June time.
The other ones are sort of manholes in the middle of the road.
That's right, yeah. So the manhole covers, obviously it's a cover, but around the edge you've got a small crack, and silt's very fine stuff, so it just washes down those cracks. And especially if the chamber blow's not in use, then over time it just builds up in the bottom of the chamber, and yeah, you've got a blockage there before you've even started using it.
Yeah, I suppose with those, someone has to go down there and actually clean that out, don't they?
Yeah, so therefore you've got a cost for labour there to do that.
Yeah, and obviously a safety risk as well.
Safety risk.
It's confined space.
Not an easy job. So the MuckStopper then is like a secondary plate, and it sits below the manhole cover and frame. So all the silt goes through the cover, around the crack, like I said, and then it just sits on top of our MuckStopper plate. And then if you ever need to access the chamber at any point during the construction phase, then you lift the manhole cover like you normally would, and then you would just scrape the silt off the top of our MuckStopper.
So you've still got access,
yeah,
but you've also got a silt block there,
yeah,
which is the MuckStopper.
Yeah, good way of putting it, silt block, yeah.
What other solutions are there already on the market? Is there anything that does that kind of thing?
It's been talked about a bit recently, but yeah, ours is ultimately designed for that very thing. There's a lot of things out there which maybe would do a similar job.
Yeah, like people say they put a bit of terrain under there, or
yeah,
geotextile.
Yeah.
Does that not really work? Or
it works up to a point, but then as soon as you want to access the chamber for any reason or to inspect it, you've obviously got to punch a hole in the geotextile, and then you're
back to square one, because that's gone, you can't replace it.
Yeah.
So obviously with ours, you've got the lid that can be put back in place.
Yeah, so you can go in and out the chamber as many times as you like. Before we launched it properly, we thought, you know, we'd give it a good trial out on site, which is exactly what we've done. So yeah, about a year now, and we went and viewed it the other day, and it was completely covered in silt. So yeah, we scraped it off, the cover out, and a nice clean chamber below.
Brilliant, so that's done its job perfectly.
Yeah.
And there's obviously the video, separate video you can go and watch of what the project manager there, David, had to say. So moving on to the other side of the system, we've got the inspection chambers around the plots. Obviously there's different sizes of that, so do you want to just talk me through the four different products in the range?
Yeah, so you've got four different size chambers, really. You've got the small mini IC chambers, so that's sort of from 250 up to 320 size. Then you've got the 450 manhole chambers, then you've got the 500mm, and then you've got the 600mm circular plastic chambers as well.
Of those ones, what's available at the moment?
We started with the 450, and that's been proving to be very beneficial to a lot of sites already. We've passed our 1,000 mark now, so I think it's nearly 1,200 now, yeah. Yeah, like I say, so we've got nearly 1,200 out on sites now, so that's covering quite a few sites around the country. And yeah, a lot of positive feedback so far. So
how does the MuckStopper 450 actually work.
So it's this one, it actually drops down the chamber itself. So you push that down to the bottom of the chamber, it sits on top of the base, and it's just sat there during the construction phase to catch any debris which comes down the chamber. Obviously they would need checking throughout the construction phase to make sure they don't get too full and just be emptied as required.
Yeah, and it comes with a pole, doesn't it? It's part of the...
That's right, yeah. So it's got a chain and hook design. And like you say, Mark, we've got a pole with a hook on the bottom of it. You would pull the MuckStopper out with a pole, empty it out, like you've probably seen on various of our videos, and empty it out, pop it back down the chamber. We're looking for it to last quite a long time. Obviously, it's a new product, so we don't know how long it's going to last yet, but we've fairly rigorously tested it in the prototype stage, throwing some concrete blocks at it, and it's stood the test of time so far.
I think customer feedback's been good as well. Customers have been saying they think it's a very robust product, fit for purpose, and it will stand up to the sort of use it will get on site.
Yeah, no, we've tried to design it to last as long as possible and obviously keep the cost down at the same time.
And then, okay, so the other ones in that range, are they kind of following the same principle?
Yeah, similar principle. The small chambers, so the 250 up to the 320, we're calling that the MuckStopper 300. Similar principle, apart from it's got a handle on the top, because obviously those chambers only go to 600 deep anyway, so you could reach in and pull that one out by hand. But the other three in the range, you will use the pole to pull them out, and they've got the hook and chains on.
Yeah, I see. And that pole's, how tall can that be?
So it comes in a set of 4 metres. So you've got their 1 metre sections and you screw them together to form a 4 metre pole. So it's designed to go into a three metre chamber, really. So you've got a metre still out the top.
And why has it got the brushes on the edge?
Mainly that's designed really to fit in any make chamber. So you've got like polypipe, which is probably one of the larger sizes in the 450 range. And then you've got Wavin, the Osmo pot, which is slightly smaller by say 10
So it gives a bit of tolerance. Millimeters.
Yeah. So yeah, the brushes basically take up the tolerance, and then you can use one MuckStopper for any make.
And it also, I suppose, it helps sort of sweep any mud that's maybe down the side of the chamber.
Yeah, so if there's anything that's got caught on the rising sections, sweeps it off on the way up.
So, and obviously if you look at the quality of the product, that's cost-effective solution really for what it's providing.
Yes, that's been encouraging that we managed to keep the price down as well as getting the quality out there.
If a developer's watched this, a house builder, and they're interested, you know, what next steps could we do in terms of working with them to trial the solution or test it?
So we want it to be a win-win for everybody, and yeah, open to any feedback. Welcome you to come and trial the product and make it a general practice, really, is what we're looking for, isn't it?
I suppose we can offer product demonstrations, can't we, on their sites?
Sure.
We're willing to travel to location and test it on different sites. And obviously we've got a lot more products coming, new developments and things that we're working on.
Yeah.
We'd be open to sort of working with selected partners on that, wouldn't we?
We were thinking this is just the start of our journey. We've got a lot of innovations to be looking at in the future, all aimed at making everybody's life easier, better practices on site. Health and safety is obviously a big thing these days, and yeah, looking after the environment as much as we can.
Okay, well, thank you very much for your time.
No problem.
Yeah, if you'd like to look into the MuckStopper system further for your projects, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us here at Drainfast, and please remember to like, share and subscribe.